HCAM programming is supported by our viewers. Thank you. And by Golden Pond Assisted Living, honoring resident choice, dignity, and independence. Our health and wellness focus keeps residents active. Golden Pond, state-of-the-art senior housing and healthcare services.
And by WPC Pest Control, a family-owned business for over 35 years. Owners Jim and Rebecca Mazzucchelli provide honesty, respect, and integrity, performing safe and effective pest control services. They service your home like it's their home.
Hello, and welcome to this edition of HCAM News. Tom Nappe at the anchor desk, and on this edition of HCAM News, we'll reflect back on some of the happenings throughout 2016. A large turnout was on hand as the Hopkinton Police Foundation hosted their annual fishing derby this past summer. The event took place during a beautiful weekend afternoon at the Hopkinton Sportsman's Club.
It's a great event that we have for the kids. We've been having it for several years. Matter of fact, we have Cabela's that came today to bring some gifts and some fishing poles and worms, which was awesome. And the gentleman that came, actually in 1983 when we had the fishing derby, he won the biggest fish, and he actually brought his trophy with him today. So that was pretty exciting. I wasn't here in 1983, but it was pretty exciting to hear that this derby's been going on since then. We've taken a couple years off here and there, but as you can see, it's a great event for the kids.
Is there a lot of fish being caught today? Have you seen any?
Yeah, lots of fish. On the board over there, you'll see how many fish have been caught today. We paid $1,000 and had the pond stocked with the trout. There's also two golden trout in there somewhere where nobody caught them today.
So they get a special prize if they catch those?
Yeah, we have fishing poles for them. They don't get a trophy, but we have lots of trophies. We have three trophies for first place, first, second, and third place. We have a trophy for the smallest. We have a trophy for the first fish caught and the most fish caught.
All right, and how do you like this weather for a day?
Oh, we had it perfect because last week it was supposed to rain today, and so I was a little nervous. But, you know, we have this rain or shine. And then, as you see, we do hot dogs and hamburgers. Dunkin' Donuts donated all kinds of donuts. And bagels, hot chocolate, and coffee. It's a great, you know, a lot of the businesses in town donated to have this event happen today, which is great, and I thank them so much for allowing this to happen.
All right, and I gotta say, congratulations on your recent award from the Juvenile Police Association.
Oh, thanks. It was an honor, so thank you so much.
Enjoy your day.
All right, beautiful day for the fishing derby event today. How's your day going out there?
Not too good. I didn't catch any fish. I better catch some bad guys than fish. But it's a beautiful day. Obviously, from the board, several people have been lucky, but not me.
All right. Can you talk about this event and what it's for?
Yeah, it's one of the things, of the many things that officers do to get involved in the community, help out, and just let them know that our officers, you know, are friendly and want to be part of this community. Phil Powers does an outstanding job. He spearheaded the whole event. He's been doing it for years, and he puts a lot of time and effort into it, and it's just a way of giving back to the community.
Having fun out there?
Yeah.
Did you catch anything?
Two fish or three.
Wow, you're doing good. Are they big fish?
No, not yet.
Where do you usually fish?
We fish across the street at the lake we have across our street, Lake Hall. White Hall.
Oh, you go fishing a lot?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so you're experienced.
Yeah.
You got the advantage here today.
That's why I have the
hat.
All right. Last fish caught. Evan, where's Evan? All right, Evan.
Right here.
All right, Evan. And the trophy, last fish caught. Great job, all right?
And here's a $25 gift card to Cabela's.
All right.
Thank you.
First fish. Where's Julia? There you go. First fish. Oops.
That's all right.
We were using your trophy to hold up the sign. Sorry, you don't get it. Jazz kid. There you go. The hat from Cabela's. All right. Moe's fish. Cassie, where are you, Cassie? You must have got your exercise going back and forth today. Cassie had 16 fish. Good job.
Any of Moe's fish?
Moe's fish.
There you go. And there's a fishing bag from Cabela's.
Cassie's a cheerleader.
HHS.
All right. So third place for the biggest fish is Madison. Madison Hadley. She here?
Hey!
There you go. Great job.
And there's a $25 gift card to Cabela's.
Oh, great job.
Hold on, let me grab a picture. Thank you.
Good job. Liam Stewart for the second biggest fish.
He's not here yet, but I'll get it to him.
Okay. All right. And then the first, where's Nina? Nina caught the biggest fish. Woo! That is so awesome. She was also tied for the first fish caught, too. Good job.
And you get that big tackle box.
And there you go. You got a big tackle box. Or you could use it for a lunch box. You could bring me lunch at the school.
Hey, hold on. Can I get a picture?
Thank you so much. Congratulations.
Over 400 wives of Massachusetts state police officers are participating in a campaign to cover the state with blue ribbons. The ribbons are being placed on trees and poles throughout the state to show support for law enforcement and their families. Molly Hanchett and Becky Canty were welcomed to bring the program into town and received help from the Hopkinton Police Department.
All right, so we are here on behalf of the Massachusetts State Police Wives to support all of our local officers. We want to make sure that everyone knows they have support from all of us, because right now in the world it's a little crazy and upsetting. So this
when
is
they see these
support.
Ribbons, we want them to know that we're thinking of you guys and that we're all behind you, the families, the local law enforcement, the state law enforcement. We're all a family here, so we just want you all to know that we're backing you 110%. When you see these, think of the families, the friends, local law enforcement. We're all backing you.
Chief Lee?
We certainly appreciate this. Seems like every day now you turn on the news, you're reading about another tragic event in the newspaper about an officer falling. Obviously what happened in Texas and other communities, it's surreal what's been going on with law enforcement. And in the news, a lot of protests against police. But we have good officers here in Hopkinton and all over the nation. And we just continue to keep your chin up and do your job that you sworn to do. But it really leaves a good feeling when we get support like this in these tough times for police. And we really do appreciate it. Thank you very much.
So we're supporting the Mass State Police. We're the wives of local police officers, and we just want everyone in their whole community to know that we're there to support all law enforcement. Yes, the Mass State Police Wives has led the way hanging the blue ribbons, but we want everyone to know that we're out there for you. So when you see these blue ribbons, we want you to know that we're thinking of you, we support you, we back you 100%. We're thinking of the family members, we're thinking of all the law enforcement, the Mass State Police community, as well as all the local law enforcement. So that's really our main goal here, is to put up these ribbons. When people see them, know that you have a community supporting you.
And we'd also like to encourage all local people to hang them on their trees and their front lawn to show their own support. Know that, then you know that there's people that have your back in town. Each town, we're trying to get in every town in the state, and so this way it shows the support, knowing that the respect is still there.
And I understand you've done a number of towns already. Can you just talk about some of the towns you did and some of the towns you are going to do?
I know there are towns in Groton. We're doing Hopkinton tonight on Monday. I'll be leading the way for Marlboro on Thursday at 4 p.m. Sudbury will be short thereafter in the next couple of weeks.
And I'm waiting back to hear from Milford, and we're trying to get in Westboro. I know there's some other ones out west that have been done already. I don't know all the towns. I know they're still working on, like...
Yeah, I think the Berkshires were covered. We're also going to try to get into Ashland as well. So, like she said, we are looking for other folks' support, even other wives of other departments, to come out to lead the way, putting more ribbons up. The more, the merrier, because, again, when you see them, you know that you're backed.
So how did this Blue Ribbon program get started?
The wives of one of the troopers has started the MSP Wives, and it was really for support initially for all the women, all the wives out there that their husbands are working midnights and getting those shifts so that no one's home when they have the newborn or there's a function on the weekend and you're left alone. So it really started as support for one another, and then all the tragedies started happening around the country, and we thought that it was a good way to show our support for other departments, that we understand, we know what you've gone through, and really the Blue Ribbon came from the Thin Blue Line of the police support.
Yeah, we've kind of actually been in charge of getting our own ribbon. So we've had a great support from the Sunnyside Gardens in Hopkinton. Mary there actually made a bunch of ribbons, these ones that are hanging here, and donated them. So thank you again to Sunnyside. We really appreciate it. But all the other ribbons that you're seeing really are coming from the wives in the local communities, where we found some good ways of keeping a budget low. So we purchased tablecloths, we cut them the long ways, buy some mesh ribbon and hang them up. So it's all of your creative genes are welcome here. I am not creative, but the Mass State Police Wives in the Facebook group have been showing us examples that we're following.
HCAM News is supported by our viewers and by Hopkinton Drug, located in this historic New England town since 1954. They are a multifaceted store dedicated to providing clients with an array of healthcare options.
And by Webster First Federal Credit Union, providing financial products with attentive customer service to the local families and businesses of Hopkinton. Visit us at WebsterFirst.com. This year, the annual Touch a Truck and Food Truck Festival raised $14,000 towards the renovation and expansion efforts of the Hopkinton Public Library. The event took place in the Hopkinton High School parking lot and featured many various construction trucks, equipment, fire trucks, police cars, and more. The event also featured some terrific food trucks, including some brick oven pizza and the ever so popular ice cream truck. A good time was had by all, and transportation was made easy by the roaming railroad.
Today we've got the fifth annual Touch a Truck for the Hopkinton Public Library Foundation. We basically have over 60 trucks here and 9 food trucks. We started off with 20 trucks and now we've got close to 60. We added the food last year, and last year in the rain we had over 1,000 people. So we're hoping this year that we can have 1,500. This year we have our Hoptoberfest again in October, which we sold out last year in 3 weeks, so we are excited for that. We raise normally over $30,000 for that. And then we're in the works to start planning a gala for when our library actually opens up next spring. So we're pretty excited for that. And any of our 1,000 Homes members are going to get a sneak preview of the library once the steel goes up, so they can see what they've been a part of.
You can view pictures of the annual Touch a Truck and Food Festival, as well as many other Hopkinton events, at sceneinhopkinton.org. If you see a picture you like and want to hold on to, the pictures are available for download. Here is a look at some more scenes from the 2016 Touch a Truck and Food Festival.
Today, myself and my friend Dave Fall and Shannon Jackman put together 22 push-ups to honor our military men and women that ultimately take their lives each and every day to suicide. We also pushed one, we call it the plus one, for active duty military men and women that also ultimately take their lives every day. So the 22 plus one is 22 veterans each and every day that commit suicide due to the physical and psychological wounds of war and or serving in the military. Plus one is active duty.
All right, so we are here live with the Hopkinton Police and Fire Department getting ready to get down to do 22 push-ups plus one for active duty military men and women. So these men and women are going to join Dave Fall and myself to do 22 plus one.
Real quick, can we say hi to Chief Lee, the Hopkinton Police Department? Sir, thank you very much for having us out here today. The Hopkinton Police and Fire Department, and we have an Ashland firefighter down here also. All right, so let's have everybody get down.
Right.
Are we ready?
Yeah.
And exercise.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, eleven, twelve, thirteen, fourteen, fifteen, sixteen, seventeen, eighteen, nineteen, twenty-one, twenty-two, and one more. Twenty-three. Honestly, I just started doing some push-ups. Went live on Facebook, and I hooked up with Miss Vivarius there, and we just been going ever since then. And then we decided to do the stride and ride relay together. So that's how we ended up, just through coincidence, I guess you could say.
Right. So is it a regular? So it's safe to say on a regular basis you're going from station to station, town to town.
Yes, sir. I try to make sure I can get where I can to raise as much awareness as possible. I was down in Cabo last year doing. We had a fire department in Cabo, St. Lucas. So yeah, I've been traveling around trying to do it and raise as much awareness as possible.
Okay, and I noticed that you get the police and fire involved. Why do you involve police and fire?
It's very important to bridge that gap because these men and women also serve on those thin lines. And so Shana had reached out to me and asked if we would come out here and do 22 push-ups. And many people may or may not know that we actually lose 2 to 3 police officers every week to suicide and 2 firefighters, paramedics to suicide as well every week. So that's another 5. And you know, many of these men and women are also veterans. So it's very important because when these veterans serve, when they come home, they want to continue that service to the people and to our country. So ultimately they become firefighters, police officers, EMS, paramedics, dispatchers even. And they get in that line and they do something that's greater than themselves. They give so much, so selflessly. So we get out here, we push for our veterans, but when we're pushing for our veterans, we're pushing for our first responders and civilians struggling. So to give people that hope that so many people need nowadays.
Excellent. All right, what else is coming up?
We actually have a big event. It's going to be honoring our military men and women. October 7th through the 14th, 2017, we're doing an event called Stride and Ride Relay, which is the significance of October 7th, 2001 is because that was when our men and women were deployed after 9/11. So we're creating this event called Stride and Ride Relay, which will kick off on October 7, 2017. We will relay to every single 9/11 location where 9/11 occurred to pay our respects to the 2,977 victims, give our thanks to the first responders who stepped up that very faithful day and continued to step up until this day. But it is to honor and remember our military men and women who've paid the ultimate sacrifice and those that are still serving and sacrificing 15 years later, and obviously in 2017, it'll be 16 years later. And so that's what Stride and Ride Relay is about. It's about giving thanks to those men and women that are still serving and really all that have served past, present, and future. And to give our thanks to first responders and never forget the victims of 9/11.
What made you decide to bring this to Hopkinton?
Well, my good friend Heather was posting doing 22 push-ups at the starting line, and her and I share the same passion to give it back to our veterans and bringing awareness to not often spoken about or talked about veteran suicide. It also happens in law enforcement and also in the fire departments for everything that they see every day. So when I found out she was only just down the street, I was like, you need to come over here. And she's like, yeah, I would love to, but I would love the police and fire to be part of it. So I was like, let me talk to my chief. Let's get this going. So in a matter of just 2 weeks, because I didn't want to wait too long. I just wanted to get it done and get everyone involved and not hesitate. And so the chief, I sent a message to him and told him all about the program and the organization, what they do, and the cause. And he was like, absolutely. He didn't hesitate. He wrote right back. And it wasn't even on hours. He was off duty and definitely responded quickly, like, let's do this. So I posted to everyone with the fire department and the police department and said, hey, guys, this is an amazing cause. Let's kind of join in together and do 22 push-ups. Because we have a lot of physically fit people, you know, so I'm like, you can do 22. So it's not too bad.
The fourth annual Live for Evan 5K took place. The event is in honor of Evan Girardi, who was born with a congenital heart defect.
All week long, we've been tracking plus 15 or 20 people per day over where we were the first year, which was our record year for attendance. So if the rest of the week went okay, we should have broke our record of attendance. We were shooting for 600-ish, over 600. We'll see how it came out later today, but yeah, it's fabulous.
Evan would face many challenges, including heart surgery, but always kept a smile on his face and pushed forward. Evan passed away due to heart complications in 2010, but Evan's friends and family continue to remember him through the Live for Evan organization, which serves to help families or people affected by heart disease.
So my name is Whitney Mullen, and Live for Evan was started about 4 years ago. A little background on the organization. And one of our childhood friends who passed away from congenital heart disease in 2012. So this is our fourth event, and we're raising money to support families of patients affected by cardiac disease. And our latest program is an apartment housing project. So we raise money to open up apartment buildings for families that travel into the Boston area while the child receives treatment from Children's Hospital. They get to stay in a place that's, you know, comfort of their own home right next to the hospital. So we're fundraising. We opened our first apartment building this year, and the money from this event will go towards opening another apartment in Boston. I do the marketing for the event, and we grew up with Evan, so we're really excited to have this be the fourth race for the year.
All the co-founders of Live for Evan grew up with Evan. He was in my third grade class. That's when I met him for the first time, and we became lifelong friends. And I think the type of person that Evan was is the reason why the volunteers and the organization itself is able to sustain itself, because everyone has such passion for remembering him in the way that he deserves to be remembered. And so it's taking a horrific situation from when he passed from his congenital heart defect and trying to create something positive out of it and help other people, because that's what Evan would have wanted. And so it's a terrific honor for us to commemorate him in this manner. And so it's been fantastic. My personal role for the organization is the treasurer, kind of the numbers guy for the organization. Which works out well, because that's what I do in my day job as well. So I'll tally up after today's over. I'll tally up all the donations, all the registration numbers, all the sponsorships, and we'll see where we're at. As I look out the field right now, I'm very confident in how we're going to end up.
The Live for Evan Memorial 5K always has a lot of community support and sponsors.
I just want to add a thank you to all of the, we have so many, we have over 100 volunteers each year, and the list keeps increasing, and we have we have over 600 runners. So it's just an immense amount of support from the community, from our sponsors, from vendors, from everyone that's pitched out and helped over the years. And just, we're really thankful for the community to continue to grow, and it warms our hearts, and we love spreading heart happiness. So we just hope we can continue to do it year to year.
So yeah, we want to thank all of our sponsors this year. That includes Select, Middlesex Savings Bank, Landscape Depot, TJ supplied the burgers and dogs, Loyola University, where Evan went to school down in Maryland, CVS Pharmacy, new to town, was our platinum sponsor. We also want to thank Gil Bain, Unibank, also a new addition, Arteriosite Medical Systems, Yogurt Beach for having a great event on Thursday night, Corporate Communications for all the signage that you see around the field today. Also, Aereo Marketing, who puts together our website and does a fantastic job at that. Scott's Landscaping, at Phipps Insurance, and Liquid Graphics Design. So a huge thank you to all the sponsors. We really appreciate having you guys. And what you guys do is what allows us to open up apartments in the Boston area. And without your help, we wouldn't be able to continue to open up more and to continue to grow and do this year over year. So we very much appreciate it.
This year's Live for Evan event featured a few new fun family activities.
We got two new events this year. We got a cornhole tournament going on over in the end zone by the high school. And we also have an obstacle course, which you can probably see in the background here, for kids K through 8th. And those are going to be events that we have continuously every year. So if you couldn't make it out this year and you want to play cornhole next year, we're going to have it. If you have kids in K through 8th grade and they want to go to the obstacle course, bring them on out next year.
The Live for Evan organization this year set up housing near the Boston Children's Hospital to help people who need a place to stay while a loved one is being treated for a medical condition.
Yeah, so the big project for us this year was we have leased a Live for Evan patient housing apartment down next to Children's Hospital on the 14th floor of the building next to our Children's. We've fully paid for that apartment. All the utilities were paid, TV, electric, heat, fully furnished.
That will just about do it for this edition of HCAM News. Don't forget to stay up to date with everything Hopkinton by checking out our website, hcam.tv, as well as our Twitter and Facebook page. If there is a photo, video, or story idea you would like to share with us, feel free to email me at news@hcam.tv. With your help, we'll cover even more of our community. For everyone here at HCAM, I'm Tom Nappy. We leave you now with the current community listings and upcoming government meetings. From everyone here at HCAM, happy holidays and happy New Year's to you and your family. HCAM is supported by our viewers and by Blackstone Valley Wealth Management, providing highly personalized financial planning, wealth management, and customized solutions through transparent, unbiased advice. Visit us at blackstonevalleywealth.com.